that's getting older ain't for cowards. It's getting older's a lot to go through.
When I first started writing for this record, I didn't know I was writing for a record. I was just writing songs. All the songs for this record were written probably in over a 12-day period. And then once I realized that all the songs were kind of going in a specific direction, then I started chasing that, started going after that, started trying to write songs that were in the American folk songbook tradition.
It had sent me the material. I think John wrote the material very quickly in like a week or two, anticipating just going and doing that kind of record. He called up and said, you want to come make a record in a week? And I said, absolutely, those are my favorite kind of records. We were going to do it with just him and his acoustic guitar.
We weren't exactly sure what we were going to end up with when we started.
There's a spontaneity to John, but there's also this method, I think. It's kind of that yin and yang with him. He's thinking through how he wants it to go. He has definite opinions and ideas of how I think he envisions the song when it's finished.
You know, John is a great storyteller. The thing I locked onto was that every one of the songs was a story and very evocative.
Wonderful tremolo and reverb guitars on it, and background vocals. I think it served the song well.
You have to look at the original song itself, playing it on an acoustic guitar, listen to the lyric, and build from there. And whatever is required to make that song live is what you have to do.
All I can do here is my best and be thankful for what we've got. What we've got. T-Bone, won't you play it and I'll go out and sing it?
Okay.
You play it and I'll sing it. I have worried about many things, most of which did not come to pass.
You know, I can only write about what I understand and what I think I understand and what I've experienced. Whenever I've tried to write songs that were just made up songs, they didn't come out so good.
So you tell yourself, I'll be back up on top someday. But you know there's nothing waiting up there for you anyway.
That might be my favorite track on the record. So it's so sparse and beautiful and aching, and it's just me and John playing, like 5 feet was between us.
Sometimes you get sick.
Two different microphones, and John had this green hat on. And I'll just never forget, I was sitting there in the big room recording, and he was singing and just living it.
Life is short, even in its longest days.
T-Bone has a history of making fantastic records, basically within the genre that we were talking about, which was what folk mixing with rock. We had great respect for him, and ultimately after working with him, I have more respect for him. An amazing arranger, amazing guitar player, amazing conceptualist.
The most important thing to me is when I finish a record, I want people to be able to hear it the way we've heard it when we finished it. we're going to start releasing records, all of the records that I do that I'm going to release under this a new set of standards we're calling Code. We're going to offer people the kind of sonic experience that musicians have. Code is going to be a little bit like THX. We're going to be, in essence, an outsourced quality control system.
I really applaud T-Bone for wanting to bring back, you know, fidelity, because it's the art form. It's part of our art.
So it's time to switch now. It's time to switch from this degraded experience to a much higher level experience. And that's what we're going to attempt to do. John's record is the first record we're going to put out in Code.
Making this record was, I think, a very eye-opening experience for everybody who was involved with it. We were able to see the possibilities, taking a small little fragile song and just adding a few little fragile parts to it and trying to make something beautiful.
It was so much fun making the record. We were doing 3 and 4 songs a day in some cases. It was just very inspired, very quick, you know, quick and dirty.
If there's anyone who's ever been interested in John, I think they're gonna really hear him. I think they're gonna hear a very unvarnished version of him.
It's definitively him every time. It's not like you hear a song, even on this record, you hear it and you don't know that it's John. You know it's John every time. So identifiable, but yet it's always new, and I really respect him for that.
The ability to write a great song with the fewest words possible, the fewest musical notes, and the most impact is what he's striving for. I know that's what a great songwriter strives for, and I think that he's finally reached his zenith on this record.
Sweet love standing at my gate.